one other thing. While you're at Piraeus Spaceport, have a word with Cedric Kincannon. I know Cedric. There's nothing he wants more than a chance to eliminate Ludovico. We could use him on our side. Best of luck, Inspector. I'm counting on you.
I wanted to ask you about Belinda.
I'm not accustomed to talking about Belinda, but I'm also not accustomed to the kind of sympathy you showed me earlier. So I'll make an exception for you. Belinda and I shared the role of Helen, but she was also the only person who knew the real me. To the rest of the colony, I'm Halcyon Helen, but to my sister, I was just Ruth.
But to herself?
I could be myself around Belinda, and she could be herself around me. She was my only sister, but she was also my only friend.
But the thing that sucks about living as Belinda is that everyone thinks she's Helen, so it's like she doesn't have her own identity, almost. It's like she has a secret identity. But I don't know. It's gotta be tough walking around pretending to be someone else. And then, I don't know. Kind of invalidates your life as a human being. Right. People know you're Ruth Bellamy. Was it hard for Belinda to keep herself secret?
No. Belinda enjoyed the secrecy. She could slip into the role of Halcyon Helen, attend social events on my behalf, perform a few stunts, deliver a few lines. And then, when she grew tired of all the people and all the attention, all she had to do was slip out of the role and be my sister again.
But
she was the secret twin. She had a comfortable life in the shadows, an easier life. I made sure of that.
But she didn't have her own life. She couldn't slip out of it because she'd walk around and everybody'd be like, Ruth, Halcyon Helen, they'd just be not, you know. I mean, did she have friends who knew who she really was? I mean, this is a huge thing. She was important to you. She was important to you. If I were you, I'd want revenge too.
What I want is my sister back. But I'll settle for killing Ludovico.
But nobody else knew you had a twin sister?
Parents, naturally. An agent, a couple of directors. None of them had any reason to reveal the truth. To them, Helen was a brand. Revealing our secret meant damaging that brand. Damaging that brand meant losing money. Nobody in this colony wants to lose money. Hmm. Belinda and I saw Helen as an act of theatric sleight of hand. We enjoyed the deception, the challenge. We wanted to see how far we could go.
I can't imagine you thought it'd end this way.
No. Frankly, I imagined we'd retire and skip to a cozy little resort colony a few stars away. One day, some enterprising fan would track us down for a documentary about the two Helens. It should have been me in that ballroom. Belinda died because I was careless. Never mind that. If you've got something else to ask me, now's the time.
That's all I wanted to know.
I'm glad I could satisfy your curiosity.
I do want to hear the whole story. Tell me what happened.
It's a long story, Inspector.
I've got time.
It was supposed to be just another marketing job. Rizzo's wanted Halcyon Helen to be the face of Spectrum Brown. Some hideous concoction served with a dead parasite.
Not dead, though.
All we had to do was spend a few weeks on Eridanos. Shake some hands, sign a few autographs, drink a bottle of Spectrum Brown in front of a camera, and try to smile. Belinda didn't want to go. But I wanted a change of scenery. In any case, we couldn't possibly say no.
Why didn't Belinda want to go?
Belinda always hated endorsement deals. They felt cheap to her. Inauthentic. She always believed her first priority was to our fans, and not the company that bought us out.
What made her change her mind?
Nothing. She took the job when I did. Belinda was an idealist, and her ideals died with her. Belinda and I arrived on Eridanos and played our usual game of trading places. We were practically flawless. Even Ludovico didn't know about us. Belinda was unhappy for the first few days. But then she met Bertie Holcomb. Bertie treated her like a human being and not just an Aetherwave icon. They were just about perfect.
So was those two together. Except for his temper tantrum, I found the ruined picnic.
Bertie has a dreadful temper. I was worried about Belinda for a while, but she told me he'd never lay a finger on her, and I took her at her word. Bertie wasn't the person I should have kept an eye on. It was Ludovico. I had a feeling Ludovico was hiding something. Belinda stayed busy socializing with the celebrities around the complex. That gave me some time to do a little digging.
So you made your way to the orchards and left me my first clue.
The Purpleberry Orchards was the heart of Ludovico's operations. I knew I'd find some answers in the R&D lab. I saw everything. The test subjects, the parasites. Spectrum Brown was never safe to drink. Those harmless dead parasites at the bottom of every bottle. They were just dormant. They would have sold out in a month. This colony loves novelty. They'll eat up any new product we toss their way. A new cereal, a new Spectrum flavor. Ludovico knows that. From Emerald Vale to Byzantium. A parasite in every brain and a grin on every face. Every last one of us trapped behind a mask of joy. That's what Ludovico wants.
Ludovico realized what you were up to. He thought you'd expose his plans.
I was careless. I was risking Belinda's life every step of the way, and I never even realized.
Don't blame yourself.
I wish it were that easy. Still, thank you. Was there something else you wanted to talk about?
Kinda like your style, murdering anybody you want in the name of revenge.
I can't tell if you're being sarcastic, and that worries me a little.
Slightly.
Leora Blossom and Maria Keen were on Ludovico's side. They chose to stand between me and my sister's killer. I had to cross them off.
What exactly happened between you and Constable Keen?
Would you believe me if I said I gave the constable a chance? I spoke to her in her office. I told her everything. Belinda, Ludovico, the parasites, all of it. Maria said I was guilty of corporate sabotage and that she had a duty to report me. She told me how sorry she was, and I told her the same thing. And then I shot her. Maria was defending my sister's killer. If someone murdered one of your crew in cold blood, what would you do?
I would have made them pay.
So you do understand. Was there anything else?
What exactly happened on the night of the murder?
You don't know how many times I relived this moment in my mind. I discovered what Ludovico was up to when I toured the orchards. I threatened to expose his plan. Ludovico decided to eliminate me. He programmed Burbage 3001 to fire on his command and disabled the security cameras in the ballroom. Only, he didn't know about Belinda. I'm sure he thought it was my skull he caved in with a bottle of Spectrum Brown. Burbage covered his blow with a plasma shot, and then Ludovico wiped his memory.
Damn. That's when you decided to hunt him down?
Something like that. I had a problem I had to sort out first. You. You were an unknown variable.
Oh, here we go.
I didn't know what to make of you.
The unknown variable.
I went after Leora Blossom, and you were just one step behind me. I programmed an automech to steal some explosives from Cedric, but you weren't far behind. You were always hot on my heels, one step behind and catching up. I realized I'd have to throw in with you or eliminate you.
Well, you would have lost that fight, but it's funny. She says the unknown. At the end of the base game, they said I was the unplanned variable, I believe it was. So I decided to name the last episode that. The unplanned variable. Well, So if you eliminate, you would have lost that fight.
I like your confidence. Take that with you when you hunt down Ludovico.
Birdie was carrying this data pad. I think it's yours.
Yes, this is mine. I'd kept notes on everything I suspected. Everything I'd discovered. It's all here. All in code. Belinda and I... we had a secret way of communicating.
I want
to
read it.
Words and phrases that had a special meaning to us.
Decode it.
Numbers and dates that were only important to the two of us.
Decode
it. Only two people in the universe knew that language.
I'm sorry. I want to read it. I want you to decode it.
Thank you, Hawthorne. Keep the data pad. All it's going to do is remind me of things I could never say to Belinda.
Okay. I can't read it, though. I just want to read it. Data pad. Well, this is junk, not... There's a... Oh, I'm a junior deputy. Which one's hers? Helen's data pad. I wanna her to decode it. Okay. Decode the data pad.
Hello, Inspector. What can I do for you?
Nothing at all. Right, so... you've discovered a formula for an effective antiparasitic. Synthesize the antiparasitic, disperse through Eridanos' atmosphere, and put an end to Ludovico's plans. You'll need the parasite egg pod. Rizzo's was harvesting them in the cave network in the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve. Got that. Cedric is a likely ally in your fight against Administrator Ludovico. Speak to him at the spaceport. And essence of sprat is an essential ingredient to your formula. The warehouse foreman in the Perea spaceport might know about it. Okay, so we're definitely going to Perea spaceport just for these two things, really.
What floor would you like to visit?
The lobby.
To the lobby we go!
She sounded like more aggressive there. So this place will probably be swarming with these people. So we're going there. Yeah, we got funky people about.
Opening fire! Perfect.
Oh, it's like writhing all over. Cool? Okay. Oh, I can just fast travel there, that's right.
Good brawl.
No friends, very bad.
I just wanted to make you smile.
The smile will be your death mask. Not sure what I'm talking about, sorry guys. Wait. We can't loot the torso, just the leg. Whoa! No friends. There's more? Yeah, it takes a lot to take these guys down. Ooh. Partially blind? No. That doesn't sound like a good thing for me. There's at least one more down there. Probably a bunch more that we can't see. Not at his desk. He's down there. Here comes that theme again. Oh, he's in there? It looks like he's inside the sublight storage and processing. You got turned into ashes. Oh. Officer's spine titanium. Huh. I didn't see that. Definitely didn't see that before. You shouldn't be brandishing that at people.
Law, how'd you get in here alive? You are alive, yeah? And not a one of them? No, you look clean. Good, you'd better get inside with the others.
The others?
Can't promise I won't run screaming if those things break in. Just so you know.
Well, you've got a nice... Is that a toss ball stick? So I guess we're safe in here. Where's Ludovica? Foreman's up there. Cedric. Oh, he's standing up there. Hi.
Inspector, you made it. Well done. I'm afraid you may find the spaceport is, at the moment, less hospitable than usual.
Well.
My apologies. Regardless, you must have some purpose here. Do tell.
What happened here?
Whew. Whatever it was, it happened quickly. Like a wave sweeping across the shore. We were overrun.
Good analogy.
Survivors are still trickling in. We've put out a call to slug agents not at the docks to keep their distance. With the warehouse's stores, slug could hold out here for weeks, easily. Possibly months.
Ludovico's I'm working with Helen to create an anti- I'm gonna say that too, if I can. I'm working with Helen to create an antiparasitic. We need essence of sprat.
With Helen? You don't say.
It's a longer story than we have time for.
That's not terribly surprising, considering present circumstances. This antiparasitic, it would restore my people to their original, non-infected selves? Safely?
Would you rather I leave them as mind-controlled slug puppets, then?
Law, but you like your extremes, don't you?
One or the other.
Well, I'll take my people's probable cure over their guaranteed death.
There you go.
Coincidentally enough, slug can supply you with essence of sprat. Ella Tinsley, the warehouse foreman, you remember her?
Yeah.
There's a package on the desk in her office. You'll find the essence of sprat you need in there.
Who ordered essence of sprat, anyway?
Oh, I wouldn't like to say. A customer supplier confidentiality and all that. Now then, is there anything else I can do for you while you're here?
Yeah, he was prepared for this. Ludovico's behind everything. Will you help me take him down?
Oh, my. You mean Lou was up to no good this whole time?
It gets worse. He wants to infect all of the colony with the slugs.
It's an ambitious plan, I'll give him that. But tell me, why should I help you, Inspector?
You're joking.
I am. Forgive me. Humor as a coping mechanism in tense situations. You understand.
Well.
You can expect slug support. I'll arrange for my agents to meet you at the distillation station.
Okay. How'd you know I was headed there?
There are slugs in the Spectrum Brown bottles, Inspector. I am operating on the theory that this is, perhaps, not good. As thrilled as I am to assist you in taking down Lou, we have barricaded ourselves in here for a reason. Hmm. I imagine you have a plan for getting out of the spaceport safely?
Antiparasitic, remember? I'm going to disperse it.
Are you really? Inspector, you are a marvel. Excellent work. I'll admit, I'm awfully fond of my agents. To see them restored will be a great weight off my soul. Thank you.
Okay, we gotta go talk to her and get the slug thingy. She's in there. No freaking out on me. Hey.
Hey, Inspector! You're alive! That's terrific!
How you holding up?
I can't complain. Still slug-free. That is, I'm still slug, obviously, but I haven't been slugged. You know what I mean.
I need essence of sprat. Do you have any in storage?
You need... what? Why?
It's for an antiparasitic that I'm working on.
No kidding! I should have known you'd be on top of things. That must be what's on my desk. We just got it in. Couldn't find it on any of our shipping orders, and none of us could figure out what in law's name it was. You're welcome to it. Just so you know, it's got a bit of a weird smell.
Okay.
You too, Inspector.
Stay safe. Laws, yes. Essence of sprat.
I knew I smelled sprat in here.
Yep. Best not to ask. Essence of sprat. Here's the parasite egg pod. What was the other thing we needed? That we got already, I think? An egg pod. Oh. Oh, I just need the two things and recruit Cedric. Helen stole a centrifuge from the RRDD labs. Use the centrifuge found in your penthouse and synthesize a cure. Don't worry, the centrifuge is practically foolproof. Oh, that thing. Yeah. I know what that thing is. Alright. So I can just fast travel from in here? No. I have to go back out. Okay. Keep up the good work. Don't forget to brain him with that thing. Don't hit yourself. Whoops. I didn't hit that. Thought maybe I hit the mouse wheel by mistake. No, that's not it either. Okay. I can't switch to... They're gonna make us come out of here manually, aren't they? Did these things come back? These people? Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Oh. 5 bits! That'll save me. It'll save everyone. Okay, now we can re-fast travel. Penthouse. Boop. Alright, so we are to use this thing. Does Helen have anything else to say?
Good to see you, Inspector. What can I do for you?
Nothing at all. Alright. Let's use the centrifuge. Supposedly, this is supposed to be really easy. Pour in the essence of sprat and parasite eggs. The essence of sprat smells vaguely like the restigo on the groundbreaker, or possibly the cantina in Edgewater. It's difficult to place, but your eyes water all the same. The parasite eggs sink into the concoction, sizzling. You activate the centrifuge. The device does its work without any additional input from you. A swirl of bright colors entertains your eyes, and a few moments later, you hear a bright chime. Oh, no, we don't need to know all that right now. We looked at that. Alright, so we have... Antiparasitic formula. An antiparasitic synthesized from essence of sprat and egg pods can be injected into the Eridanos atmospheric controls. Now, the sprat essence definitely makes sense because there was notes on one of those terminals that say you can't... They tried to put the parasite into a sprat, but it was not compatible. It didn't work. So that's why a lot of sprats around, because they were used... Well, they wanted to use them as guinea pigs or lab rats, whatever. And, yeah, they were not viable. You developed an effective antiparasitic. Head to Phaeton, the autonomous digital astrogator located in the pilot house, and disperse the antiparasitic into the atmosphere. Sweet. Now I'm guessing we can't... We can. Yeah, I'm just going to bring these two again. Oh God! It's just a lot of them. Yikes! Yeah.
That's the last of them.
Whee. I guess these people, it makes them enjoy puking. I can't imagine. Like, I'm so happy, Borg. He looks like a normal security guard. I'm just running right over to it.
Greeting protocols suspended. All non-essential protocols suspended. Phaeton is standing by for larval compound dispersal.
What's your status?
Reactor stable. Compound dispersal may commence.
Here, disperse this instead.
Affirmative. Dispersing.
Sweet. Well, it better work for all this.
Incoming message from Rissa's distillation station.
What have you done? What in law's name have you done?
Reputation decreased.
Are you trying to kill us all? No, you're trying to kill my symbiotes.
There's also
I'm
now
going to
off
let
put.
You destroy everything I've built. I can still fix this. I can undo the damage you've done.
Never.
End of transmission.
Off put. You've stopped the spread of the parasitic infection. I want to say infestation. Same. For now, Ludovico has retreated into the depths of the distillation station. Find him and put a stop to the parasite threat once and for all. He sealed himself off. So, we're off put. Well, it says I'm neutral here. This employee needs improvement. Best employee ever. Deserves a big bonus and a promotion. I don't think they do that. On track to being a great employee. It's friendly. Anti-Cleo. It's too early to tell whether this employee is competent or not. Well, there's positive, no negative. Well, there shouldn't be any more effusive hosts or anything like that. These unfortunate souls are the last ones to be killed. Everything okay?
Inspector! Help you get that killer soon!
He's your administrator. So he's back over there at the distillation center, or station rather. Everyone's back to normal here?
I was nearly attacked by a terror ray on my way here.
Yep, back to normal, alright. So we have to run over there. But we headed the right way. But that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.